right, next up we have John Coltrane, a Love Supreme LP, and this is this is the second time this is on the show.
Yeah,
Skyzoo
one,
also
yep.
Skyzoo picked this album, and
he talked about it.
Yeah. Oh
so
yeah.
When he was on, he picked Acknowledgement, but you just said you wanted to hear Resolution.
Oh yeah.
So let's
Resolution.
Hear that. Oh yeah. Beautiful. Beautiful melody here.
So tell us about, like, how did you come across John Coltrane? Well, it had to be your father, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You know, I woke up every morning hearing him play Giant Steps on the guitar.
Oh, wow.
That's, like, every morning, that was his hurdle.
Yeah.
And he found all types of things to say on that song. In the morning, and, you know, like, his guitar ain't plugged up to nothing.
Right.
He just... It's like to the point where that song is in my bone. It's in my knuckle. It's in my brain.
Yeah.
When I hear that song, like, I'm home.
Okay.
And, you know, it's like sometimes, you know, some people in their music, they try to exude a jazzy confidence or jazzy
right.
vibe.
Right.
Like, to me, it's not like that.
Right.
You know, it's just like the punk rock thing. It's like, it's in you. You know, it's
yeah.
something that's
uh-huh.
like, I was raised with this.
Yeah.
And when every time I hear this, I think of Leimert Park, I think of New York, and I think of, even like when I was in New York, this record helped me feel like I was back home, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
Right. Okay.
Like this record helped me feel like, you know, I'm first in college, you know, freshman college, and my roommate, she sublet this little, I don't even know if that was could be called a room,
right?
You know, it was like
it's like the Harry Potter, like
yeah, yeah.
under the staircase.
Tiny home in a tiny right. apartment. Like, I don't know if that could be any, you know, but her collection of things was like stuff that I like too, you know.
Yeah.
And she had a Love Supreme in there.
Yeah.
And it's, I thank her for that because it got me through a lot
yeah.
of pain. And 9/11 happened that same
oh,
year.
Oh man.
Right.
And it was just really, really wild, you know, being on the C train right under the World Trade Center. I'm on the stop, and that's when the plane hit.
Damn.
You know.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. That's, yeah. So it's like the second plane.
Okay.
Boom. And you
and
see.
And you were on the C train underneath
yeah,
the tower.
Yeah, I was underneath the tower. And you see
Damn.
People coming in the train, you know, with the it's like you're
yeah,
in
yeah,
the
yeah.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
You know,
wow.
people's eyes is just bugging out their head, and they telling you something else is happening, and they're telling you the I-beams look like just shredding like paper, you know, like
yeah.
the people who survive, you know, like being that, and then coming out and seeing people who would never stand together in the street
right,
standing
right.
together.
Yeah.
And you thinking like, damn, this is what it's gonna really take for people to stand together.
Right, something that major and you know
tragic,
like,
yeah,
really,
yeah.
It's
yeah.
really gonna take
Yeah.
bullshit.
Right,
you know,
right,
for
right.
people to stand together in the
right.
street, no matter what it is. It's,
yeah.
Know? And those times were real fragile, man. I think now being older, when we was younger, we was just, you know, you live, you know?
Yeah.
And you have a lot of energy when you're young. You know, you just make things whatever so that you can keep on going.
Right.
But I think all of us, like, when I look back, that was really kind of deep.
Yeah.
And we
yeah.
turn to music in a real way, you know, and Coltrane, it really appealed to me the way he strived on his instrument, his spiritual struggle, you know, and he put it all in there.
Right.
You know, like whatever he was trying to achieve, he or whatever he was trying to communicate or
right.
share with the world, he went straight to his instrument and told the truth on it.
Right.
And a lot of people make the error in thinking that, like, when they're supposed to be playing jazz, that they're supposed to sound a certain way or have a certain vocabulary, which is good for a beginning, like how to start in your journey of music. But really, all you're supposed to really do is hear the music, know the melody,
right,
and then tell the truth.
Yeah.
And I feel like this is like the... I feel like Coltrane is such an incredible artist because what he did with the blues was just incredible.
Yeah.
And he went to it as a temple, a spirit. He made the blues a spiritual place.
Yeah.
Where he could confess, you know.
This album was a letter to God, essentially.
I mean, really.
Yeah, yeah.
And, I mean, seriously, I love this record since I was like a teenager. Like, I mean, even before that. I've been loving Coltrane my whole life.
Right, right.
You know? I'm assuming you
my
heard
whole life,
all that. Yeah.
But like even before I had left home, like I painted in my room, like I drew on my walls, whatever, and I had four windows in my room, and over each window I had every movement of a Love Supreme.
Nice.
Oh wow.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Just when I'm on my NPC, like,
yeah.
And
that's
I had
dope.
That, you know, so I wake up, you know, Train is like a hero and a definite angel of music, and so is Alice Coltrane.
Yeah.
Swami
yeah.
Z.
Yeah.
She's an angel of music. They achieved a certain unity and sound that we can only strive for.
Yeah. All right. John Coltrane.
Nice. Another hour.
Resolution.